Well, it's about 6 o'clock in the morning. I'm all packed up and back on the trail. And I've been up since pretty much 1 o'clock and 1 a.m. There was a pretty intense storm that came through. Some of the most lightning that I've seen yet. And the clouds look like they've more or less disappeared now. So I really hope I can do St. Louis Peak without any problems. It was raining too for like 4 or 5 straight hours. I was really wondering if I could even get out of here by 6 o'clock or 7. But it did stop and has cleared up quite a bit, so. But now this grass is just growing into the trail so much. My fucking pants are getting soaked. Shoes too. Oh boy. I think the trail just goes down there, but I think that might be Mount St. Louis. I'm gonna drop my pack and quickly run up there. What a beautiful view. Yeah, it must be St. Louis right there. I spent 3 nights in this valley right here. Did lots of fishing. Gave my body a break. It's the first time in 32 days. Today's actually day 34. Day 34 on the trail. Or here in Colorado anyway. Yay! We made it! I'm on top of St. Louis Peak. The views. What a spectacular sight. I mean, really. Wow-wee! All right, well, I am headed down. My fingers are freezing. It must be nice to have brought a pair of gloves. These rocks are really slippery, so really be careful when you go down or end up. You can easily slip. Still have the morning frost on them. Thank you. Well, I'm down off St. Louis Peak. That's the valley that I spent the last 3 nights in, fishing and relaxing. And I just put my tent or my pack just down here. Looks like the trail just goes on the side there, up there, keeps going across there, a little bit up, and over that little pass. All right, let's do it. Well, there's St. Louis Peak. It took me about 2.5 hours to get up and down from St. Louis Pass. This wasn't too bad. I'm glad I did it. Glad the weather cleared up too. From like 1 o'clock to 5 o'clock, or 4:30 or so, I should say. It was awful. Just downpouring and lightning, thundering, and no stars to be seen. St. Louis Peak. Looks like the trail just winds down here, probably a couple switchbacks right here, way over there, around, around, up and up, and then over, and there you can see it, goes probably over that pass right there, that grayer area. Bondholder Meadows. That way. CT this way. Looks like a pretty good water source. It's a nice little campsite. Right on. There's a fire pit and another little spot. Right by the water source as well. Not too shabby. Awesome views. Oh, there's another hiker up there. Cascade Creek that way, West Willow Creek that way, Continental Divide, and Colorado Trail this way. Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking earlier. That pass that we did before St. Louis Peak from that saddle. That was not St. Louis Pass. I just screwed up royally. I'm supposed to turn left on Cascade Creek, and I don't know if I seen it or not. I seen the trail, but I didn't see no creek that way or Highway 503 that way, no sign or nothing. And so I kept going on the trail. Just kept going. And it was already weird to me that the trail was just climbing too. Hell, I was fucking damn near on the peak of that shit over there. And then I realized, I guess, well, I couldn't be that far, because I figured around 10:20, 10:30, I was gonna be at that trail. And it was already 10:50. and still I was climbing, and I seen this road over here, and I figured maybe the climb that I was doing was St. Louis Pass, but that over there, St. Louis Pass, and there's no sign for that either, and I don't know how far I'm gone, or how far that I've gone today. Now, came down a little ways, and I wasn't gonna go all the way down to that trail, so now I'm cutting across this huge fucking field or whatever, and of all days, seriously, I need my resupply more than ever. I have one Cliff bar left, and I had one Nutri-Grain bar in the morning, so I've had like 125 calories, and I've already gone probably about 9 fucking miles, and I got another 10 to go if I don't get a hitch. Oh man, what a fucking pain in the ass. Seriously. Well, I see some Jeeps over here, maybe they'll take me. Damn it. Well, I hope I get a hitch. Then it wouldn't be all so bad, but I'm finally on this Jeep road that leads to 503. I hope. And had to do a bunch of bushwhacking through those shrubs or bushes. That was brutal. So muddy everywhere and no trails, thick as can be. And on top of everything that's happened today, I just fucking lost my data book amongst that whole pile of shit. Well, I just ran into a guy that was just doing some jogging up and down this hill, and he knows all these trails around the area, and told him where I went wrong, and that I'm trying to head into Crete. I only have a little bit of food left, and all this and that, and he said that he'd be maybe another hour hiking around and stuff like that, and he'd meet me down at his truck. He was gonna give me a ride into Crete. So, well, my day just went a little bit better. There's his white truck down there, he said. Said just wait down there, and he'd be down in a while. So I'm gonna go down there and rest up, because I've been pushing pretty friggin' good since 5 in the morning. So, damn it, I can't wait. Can't believe I went up that high on that ridge yet. I must have climbed like 40 minutes. That was a hurting climb too. Seriously, it was harder than St. Louis Peak. Again, with my pack and shit, but okay. Very soon now, I'll be in Crete, enjoying a brew. Let's see if they have a hostel in Crete too. Maybe spend the night there. It's been 7 days since I've even been in a town anywhere, so I think I will. Here we are, 503, yay. This must be a trail that I was supposed to get on early today, around 10:20 or 10 o'clock. So here I am, the trailhead of this Jeep trail. Now, what would they be mining like majority of time here in these mines?
Silver.
Silver?
And a little bit of gold.
This is my wide angle view camera. It pretty much sees everything you pointed at.
Yeah.